everyone, it's Justin again. Thanks for joining me today. I have got to show you this map that I found. It's so old. There's even a piece missing. I hope that's not important. You know, it's so interesting that I want to learn more about it. What type of map do you think this is? What do you think all these lines and symbols mean? Do you think it'll lead us to buried treasure? I guess we'll have to explore some maps together to find out. Hey again. Now, there are so many types of maps, we could really talk about them all day. Maps are just as diverse as the world they show us. So today, we'll just be talking about a few of the most common and important types of maps. Physical maps, political maps, and thematic maps. A physical map shows landforms, like mountains and rivers. Do you see the colors on this map of the US? The colors are there to give us information. This side is brown, and that's because it has more mountains, and the land is at a higher elevation. And this side is so green. That means that area is at a lower elevation. You could see those colors again here on this map of Egypt. We know what the colors on the map mean because this guide in the upper right corner tells us. The guide is called a map key. You might remember from a previous lesson that map keys tell us all about what the symbols on a map mean. Ooh. That looks kind of like my map, but I can't be sure yet. I think we should look at some other types of maps too. A physical map shows details of the Earth's surface, but other types of maps show us other important markers people have made. A political map helps us see the boundaries of countries and cities, like where we live. Can you see the shapes of each country on this map of the world? We can also tell them apart because they're different colors. How about this map of the United States? Can you see the shape of each state? If you look at a map of your state, you may even be able to find the boundaries of your county. So, physical maps tell us about the Earth's surface, and political maps help us find specific places, but our last kind of map helps us learn all kinds of other things. A thematic map shows information about a specific topic, like favorite ice cream flavors by state. How fun is that? But thematic maps aren't just for fun. They also show us the answers to questions a lot of people have, like how many people live in the United States? Or what's the temperature of each area of the United States? And even what types of animals are most common in each country? I think it's time for a little quiz. Can you tell whether this map is physical or thematic? That's right, it's physical. We can see the colors that tell us about the landscape in Italy. All that brown shows us that there are a lot of mountains there. Okay, how about this one? Yep, this one is thematic. It shows the population, or how many people live, in every country around the world. Okay, so which type of map do you think mine is? It does have symbols on it, so maybe it's a thematic map. We should keep digging. You know, all this map talk has made me realize that they all cover totally different areas. Some maps just show a town, but others show the whole world. Think about your town or city. It's pretty big, right? Imagine if a map was just as big as the place it was showing. Well, that wouldn't make much sense, would it? It'd be too big to fit on your table, or in your hands for that matter. Cartographers, the people who make maps, have to make them small enough to hold so we can actually use them. And that is where map scale comes in. Now, think about looking at a picture on a phone. You can zoom in to see something up close, or zoom out to see the whole image. Map scale works the same way. It helps us know how far the map has been zoomed out on. If the map scale says 1 inch equals 100 feet, it means that 1 inch on the map represents 100 feet in real life. So when we look at the map, we know that 1 inch on the map is the same as 100 feet in the actual park. And if we want to see the entire town, we'd zoom out beyond the park. On this map, the map scale might be 1 inch for every mile. So map scale is like our zoom button, helping us know how close or far the map has been zoomed out. It helps us explore big places on small pieces of paper. So that's what these lines mean. But our map doesn't show what the scale is. Huh. Let's keep learning and see if we can figure it out. And look what I just found! It's the missing piece! It was in my backpack the whole time. Now that we have this, the map makes a lot more sense. This is the map key. Oh, now I see the scale too. It says 1 inch equals 100 miles. And apparently this really cool old map is showing the favorite florals in different areas. Okay. I guess we won't find any treasure after all. A map about flowers is a little silly, but I guess people have really loved flowers for a long time. Well, great job, explorers. Today we learned about different types of maps, discovered the magic of map scale, and became experts in distinguishing physical and thematic maps. And we learned about flowers, too. Thanks for joining me today, and remember to always be clever. Hey.